Woody or actually punk no needs FM.
The responsibility of a finance minister, or I would say finance and economic plan minister here in Ghana.
Thank you very much. There are two aspects to it. First of all, because the finance minister is in charge of the budget and also the economy, he's in charge of, he's responsible for what goes on generally as far as the economy is concerned.
Really?
Yes.
And are there specific payments that one would have thought that it is the core mandate of the finance minister to be responsible?
Yes, the core mandate. I was coming to the second one, which is the fiscal, which is how we receive money, you know, from GRA, which brings in the most, and then from ministries, departments, and agencies that charge fees and other incomes, how we receive loans, how we receive grants, and then how we spend them, which is the subject of the matter.
So can somebody say the finance ministry is a spending ministry or an implementing ministry?
Yes, it is a spending ministry. First of all, the finance ministry has two natures. One, it is when you say ministries, departments, and agencies, it is a ministry, like any other ministry. So just like other ministries go to parliament with their budgets, they also go to the appropriate committee.
So it's not like you always give monies to other ministries?
We give some to ourselves.
And then you talk and about...
Yes. But then in managing the economy on a larger scale, then you have Bank of Ghana, which looks at the monetary and financial sector of the economy.
So even the Bank of Ghana operates under the auspices of the finance ministry?
No, it has autonomy, independence, and its laws, you know, non-interference. So, but when you take the economy, then there is, let me just simplify it. One, there is the fiscal side, money coming in and spending to run government projects and others. Then there is the financial side, which is how we print our money, how we use our money, because the money is the one we use to exchange, you know.
As a medium.
Things, medium of exchange, as they say in economics. And then also how, you know, we relate the, is the regulator, Bank of Ghana is the regulator for the banks, all banks, you know, that is why when you talk about bailout, then Bank of Ghana, you know, comes in. Then there are the ministries that spend, and that's what we call the real sector, and sometimes tangible and intangible. So you have Ministry of Roads, you have others, Ministry of Energy, Works and Housing, and you have all of them. So all these are playing a role in the economy, but it is the Minister of Finance who has overall responsibility, you know, like a jigsaw puzzle to make sure
that
everything is working, you know, well, yes.
Right. Yani Orasa,
and we are responsible to Parliament.
Responsible to Parliament.
Yeah.
Right. Just to do with the issues are. Yebeka, irrespective of the language. Now, who can budget? Inti, you can budget that. And no any day, say, finance minister, your budget. Now, mid-year review of the budget. And also, so any day.
Let's go to the family.
Okay.
So, in a family, there are those who earn income. And then, if you have small kids, there are those who don't earn income. And if you have adult kids, they leave and they also go and, you know, create their households, even though, so just like a family will get money, whether from daddy's salary or from mommy's salary or trading, you know, profit, not, you know, everything, that is how the money comes in. And then the family decides to spend. So you spend on rent, you spend on food, you spend on education, you spend on, you list all the items, which are household, clothing, for the kids and everything, school fees, school uniforms. So you have your income, you have expenditure. Sometimes your income is enough to meet your expenditure. Sometimes it's not enough. Sometimes, therefore, if your expenditure is higher, then you go and borrow, right? Then you plan to repay. Maybe every month or so you pay something, either from a friend, from the bank, from a family member. If you are well off, You may decide to put a buy a car, replace furniture, you know, mortgage, begin to buy blocks. Before we had mortgages and whatever, buy blocks, buy roofies and things, and build a house. It's all from the family income. So government is also like that. Government has is responsible for many things. I won't repeat, I said some of them. So government gets money foremost from taxes, which parliament authorizes the executive. It's only parliament that can authorize, you know, taxes, lower it, you know, increase it, new tax handles, you know, anything tax, it has to go to parliament. And then we have ministries, departments, and agencies like DVLA. When you go and you want to service your car, roadworthiness, and everything, you know, they also bring in income. Lands Commission, and the Ministry of Lands, and you go and pay a fee for the public servants who work there. So we have also fees apart from taxes. And then sometimes, as a developer, just like maybe the household, if you are just beginning life or something and you are struggling, maybe an uncle may give you something or your dad may give you something in addition. So similar like a country, because we are relatively poor, we have what we call grants or aid coming from outside, you know, and then sometimes we take a loan just like the household. Because even if you have enough money, sometimes even if you have enough money and you want to build a road, it may take you 5 years based on the income from GRA to build a road from here to say Kupentuni or to Nkoko or to Kumasi. But you can take a loan and finish within a year or two and then repay. So that's another way of saying, even if you have money, sometimes you borrow. Right, or you anticipate that you will get money. So that's the development part of the budget. So the budget is how government receives its income and how, and I'll show you the sources. How it spends is, first of all, it pays for government workers. Obviously, we have to pay them. Two, it pays the interest on the loan, as I described, and then it has to put some money aside to repay loans over a period of time. And then through that borrowing and others, it has to pay for development, which is roads, schools, you know, and other things. Then it has to cater for those who are not too well to do, who may need support, you know, from government.
They just said there's a budget, so can I just say, a normal budget is a five, and a finance minister, no? Or share, say, a better budget, no more, or the better to your worker?
Yeah, basically, it's a compensation or the wages for public servants, interest, you know, that you pay, and then other expenses for running government offices and government. And then there's a capital budget, you know, which is for development. And then there may be subsidies and others, you know, which is, for example, electricity up to a certain level, you know, lifeline, you know, you don't put taxes on them or whatever. And then as it goes,
there was specific period to be a. You prepare a deliver budget our parliament, Anna.
Under the constitution, you have to do it 1 month before the end of the year. And that's why the budget is always ready in November. The only time we find it difficult to read the budget in November is in an election year, like this year. Because pretty soon parliament will go on recess. And then they'll be involved in the campaigning. And the election itself is in December, first week. And normally the budget, when reading the budget is not a budget. What you read is just a budget speech.
Okay.
Sometimes people just tune out after the budget is read. But what you are reading is just an introduction to the budget.
Right? An abridged version, per se.
An abridged version, highly abridged version of the budget, just to give a flavor. But it's not the end of the. After you are finished, then before the budget, there is a, from about May, around this time, next year's budget is being prepared already. You know, so you have all the ministries bringing in their estimates, you know, their needs. Minister of Roads saying, we want to do this type of roads. You know, Western Housing saying, we want to build affordable housing. And now there's Minister of Energy saying, we need an additional plant or we need. So all of those are brought together. So the budget, the reason we don't normally read is that normally when the budget is read in early November, it takes up to about Christmas to finish approving the budget.
Okay.
And that's because
approval processes.
Yes. That's because when the minister finishes reading, he tables the budget. He reads on behalf of the president. Because the president is the one who is actually required to, you know, to present. So,
so it is not out of place for a finance minister to come to parliament and say, I am reading this budget under the instructions of the president of the republic.
That's what you have to do.
Oh, it is usual for you to do that.
That is what you have to do because the constitution requires that the president is the one who sends the budget, to, who should present the budget to parliament. So what you are doing as Minister of Finance, on behalf of the executive, the president and cabinet, and is you are only presenting it on his behalf. In fact, not on his behalf, on his authority.
Okay.
So normally if you listen to the introduction, you know, the minister starts by saying, you know, he presents bows and then presents on the authority of the
okay. of the president. Because what I'm saying that's was it somewhere 2001? Now the then finance minister, Yasaf Mafu, now you call HIPIC, now or Baby Ruti budget, no can say or the budget neighbor on the authority of the president. No. Now it said they won't play HIPIC and also into a pursue each John Kufu, into no say I'm under the authority of the president. But from what you are telling us, no, that is what he's supposed to be saying.
Yes, because HIPIC is borrowing, and our debt, which borrowing had gone to parliament for approval, and somebody is providing you with relief. And when the loan was going, it was parliament that approved the loans. In fact, Article 181 says only parliament can approve loans, only parliament can levy tax, and only parliament can determine, you know, how the money is spent. And for that, the constitution says the president should bring. So if you have taken loans in the past which parliament approved, and somebody is forgiving the loans, you have to come back to parliament.
Oh, okay.
And since you were not the one who presented in the first place,
that's right.
Then obviously you have okay. to yeah, do it.
On now, what can say normally? Who would say, oh, actually, punk no, needs FM.